So guys, we're over here at Silverstone in the UK, and we're joined by Steve Sargent, Chief Product Officer for Triumph. So Steve was the one who championed Triumph's involvement into Moto2, and this is obviously a huge undertaking for Triumph, and it's been important to you and the brand. Why has it been so important?
I mean, the interesting thing about the whole Moto2 project is that it wasn't something we actually had planned to do.
Okay.
So we got to find out about the Moto2 contract coming up for renewal via a guy who actually used to work for Triumph, who I still am in regular contact with.
Obviously.
And he's actually worked in this paddock, so he's worked in MotoGP. And it was around another conversation, actually, and he said to me, do you know that the Moto2 contract's coming up for renewal? Because if you're interested, I can put you in contact with the right people.
Right.
So I thought, not too hard about that. I thought, do you know what? If I can get that over the line internally at Triumph, that would be an absolutely awesome thing to do.
Definitely.
And that's really how it started. So we then got in contact with the guys at Dorna, and we started having an initial discussion around, you know, what are you guys looking for? What do you want to bring to the championship? What would you expect from us? You know, and it was very clear from their side that what they were looking for is to bring some excitement into the championship, bring something fresh, and also to close that gap between Moto2 and MotoGP, so it wasn't such a step for the riders and the teams to move from one to the other. So we then got into a discussion around, okay, what do you want from the engine? Number one thing they said was they've got to be reliable. Obviously, you know, in a championship that's viewed worldwide, you can't afford to, you know, stop races for any incidents or anything like that. So,
and Honda had a good run, following that is,
you know, we had a really tough act to follow. Obviously, you know, everybody said, you know, the Hondas never let anybody down. So, you know, that was in our minds for sure. But we did want to bring more performance. So, you know, we sat down and we worked out with Dorna, well, we think we can deliver this specification of engine. We think that's competitive for you guys. We're pretty confident in the reliability of that. You know, this is an engine that we've known for a long time. We've done a lot of testing on it, so we know what it can do.
Right.
And we know what it can be tuned up to. So we sat down with them and said, that's what we think we can deliver. Are you guys happy with that? And they said, yes, we think that works. And then the rest of it was really a commercial discussion around, you know, how do we make the numbers work for both of us and all that kind of stuff.
Of course, yeah. And to date, you know, you guys have been quite successful. It's been it's made for some really exciting racing. And can you fill us in on kind of some of the successes and some of those milestones that you guys have reached as far as the season goes as it stands?
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, when we kicked off, we thought, well, in our first season, if we are kind of within a second of lap records, we'd be reasonably happy with that because, you know, the teams are learning a new engine, they're learning a new chassis. So, you know, if we can get close to the existing lap records, we'd be kind of happy.
Right.
And then at the very first test with the teams in Jerez, we were already under lap records.
Right.
And it's like, oh, that's that's a bit special.
Right, definitely.
You know, so that was a real milestone. The first round at Qatar was awesome. You know, the first time we heard 32 bikes set off from the grid down to the first corner with that, you know, that triple sound.
Oh yeah,
that was just you know, that was hairs on the back of your neck.
I'm sure.
You know, and all that kind of stuff. So that was awesome. And then it just kept coming, you know, week after week. You know, we were getting lap records, top speeds, 300 kilometers an hour at Mugello. You know, first time a Moto2 bike's done over 300 kilometers an hour.
Right.
That was awesome.
So
it's just kept coming and coming.
Yeah. I think, what is it at now? 10 circuit records and
10 circuit records. Speed. It looks like we'll get the 11th here. We're already under the absolute Moto2 lap record in the first day.
Yeah.
So
it's exciting. I mean, obviously we're here in Silverstone. It getting the 11th here, it's great. But I congratulations on the success so far, and look forward to more exciting racing. And the fact that the whole field is now within a second of each other, is that what I was?
So today the top 17 were within a second. In Austria, the top 24 riders were within a second of each other during
practice.
That's amazing.
That's incredible racing. That's, you know, and that's why people, you know, enjoy watching racing at this level. It's really incredible.
I think the thing that I've enjoyed probably more than anything is seeing the guys play with the bikes. Mm-hmm. So you're seeing the guys back it into a corner. You're seeing the guys drift the bike on the way out, lifting the front wheel whilst they're drifting it on the way out. I mean, that's some awesome riding.
Yeah, and again, congratulations on what you guys have done, and we'll look forward to the rest of the season and hopefully many years in the future Triumph being a part of it.
Cool. Thank you very much. Yep. All right. Cheers, man.
Cheers. Tell us a little bit about this bike. What's special about it? Why was there a little bit of a gap in production in from the production model? And what's special about this very special edition motorcycle?
Okay. Well, it was really an opportunity.
Okay.
Okay. We're obviously supporting Moto2 with engines now. Mm-hmm. And it's been very successful this year. It's going very, very well.
Right.
And the opportunity was there to give people a chance to buy a bike that had all that character and feel that the Moto2 riders are experiencing on the track.
Yeah, yeah.
The break in production was short, but it did coincide with a change in regulations. Mm. So the previous model, it was the European regulations changed, and it was a convenient break point. Mm. But this is an opportunity, is, to just build the ultimate Daytona with a Moto2 inspired engine.
Right, and I mean, you can see this is a very premium motorcycle, premium componentry on it. You know, we've got everything from the Brembo Stylema brakes, the Olin suspension, the NYX 30 fork, the TTX 36 shock. It does look fairly similar to the outgoing model. What has changed from that previous model to this?
Okay, well, we did a lot of work on the chassis in terms of tune and setup. Mm. As you say, all those components are premium. They're there for the way they work. Mm. They're there for precision, control, and a real fast riding experience. You know, real good control at, you know, the ultimate levels of performance.
Yeah.
So we did a lot of work actually with the suspension and with the geometry and changed springs, damping, adjusted geometry, and we still came back to the same geometry. So everything looks
good,
very similar, but you've got to remember this is a very refined package. Mm-hmm. We've had the Daytona in our lineup for many years. Mm-hmm. It's had the benefit of a lot of race development with teams, privateers and teams, and been very successful.
Yeah.
And truly, it was the bike to put this engine in.
Right.
So, yeah, okay.
And then from I guess what you've learned in Moto2, how is that translated to this limited edition bike? It says Moto2 on it.
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Okay. Well, as I said, character, feel, and really torque. Mm-hmm. The engine is all about being able to deliver the power, but also torque.
Right.
And it's also response. So what you need is control. Mm-hmm. So we've learned a lot from Moto2 about this engine.
Right.
The Moto2 engine was developed from the 765 Street Triple engine, and now we've redeveloped the Moto2 engine back into a road legal version for the Daytona.
Right.
So all that we've learned from Moto2, we've continued. We've actually developed a lot of the components to an even higher level than Moto2.
Right.
Because once you add all the requirements, the legal requirements, to achieve homologation, you have to have started somewhere much higher to achieve a given level. Okay. So examples there, the intake ports are being developed further, new machining there. Mm. The intake trumpets are completely new, again, for tune and for performance.
Right.
Pistons, rods, crankshaft, all tuned, barrels as well. Everything has been taken to the next level, including higher specification materials, changes to process to give better durability, even better durability, better hardness. It's just a refinement again on top of Moto2.
Right, and I think that's an interesting point to touch on, is the fact that this, you know, you have to develop at an entirely different level because these motorcycles need to run for a customer for an amount of time. Whereas, you know, your race teams, I believe I heard, you know, you're swapping out engines every three races. And that's so the Moto2 racers can race at the highest level.
No, absolutely. We're offering this bike with a 2-year unlimited mileage warranty. Mm. Okay.
Yeah.
The service intervals, 6,000 miles, 10,000 kilometers.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that it's really easy to live with.
Right.
But you can track day it.
Yeah. And it's a great bike. I think, you know, a lucky 765 people and either Canada or the U.S. and also in Eurasia and around the country or around the world, you know, there's going to be a limited number. And unfortunately, we're also told there aren't plans for a production model after this.
This is it.
This is
the ultimate Daytona. It was a great opportunity to bring the Moto2 engine character and feel to the Daytona.
Right. And congratulations on all your success with Moto2 and how that's been going this year. And I hope it continues, obviously, for the rest of the contract. And hopefully we keep seeing Triumph in the top-level championships of the world.
Well, lovely. Thank you very much.
Thank
Cheers,
you,
mate. Cheers.